Happy New Year! Welcome back to Vintage. I hope you had a lovely Christmas and New Year, everybody. Thank you to everybody who left lovely messages on the last video of 2015. Lovely to hear from you all. I hope you all got the presents that you were after at Christmas. And if you didn't, that you got the book vouchers or indeed cold hard cash that will allow you to get the books that you wanted at Christmas. I had a very nice Christmas. Thank you very much for asking. I ate, drank and was merry. And by merry, I mean I sat around and read quite a lot of books, which is how I like to spend my Christmas. I'm very much looking forward to sharing some of those with you over the next few months. 2016 is very exciting, and there's lots of things I want to tell you about, but I have to hold myself back. I have one book to talk to you about today, but before we do that, I have to tell you who won last year's Book of the Week, which was Persepolis by Marjan Satrapi, which is a fantastic, totally classic graphic novel. So if you have not read it and you fancy it, do check it out, because I promise you won't be disappointed. But the lucky person who has won a copy is BookChat. Congratulations, BookChat. You will find my email address at the bottom of this video's description. Send me your postal address and I'll get that book off to you straight away. So, 2016. This is going to be quite a short video, because the book I want to talk to you about has a brilliantly simple premise, and I don't really want to tell you too much more about it than that. Here is the book. It's called The Invoice by Jonas Carlson. Now, he published a book last year called The Room, which was a sort of slightly quirky Scandinavian-style book about a guy who worked in an office, and it was described as sort of being a cross between The Office sitcom and Kafka. A lot of fans for that book because of its sort of slightly quirky attitude. And The Invoice is no different, really, in that it has a sort of really brilliant idea behind it. I will stop waffling and I will tell you what the idea is. Our male narrator describes what is a pretty ordinary life that he lives. He works in a video store part-time. He's sort of a pretty chilled-out guy and sort of happy with his very simple life. Then one day in the post, he receives an invoice for an insane amount of money. It's in krona, but I think in pounds we'd be talking about hundreds of thousands of pounds. And he cannot understand where this invoice has come from. So he makes some inquiries, and it turns out that basically he's being invoiced for the things that have happened in his life. So the beautiful scenery he may have seen whilst out on a walk, the breeze on his face, sunlight streaming through a window, those sort of everyday things that you think of, or wouldn't really think of as being things that you would have to pay for, he is now being invoiced for. And he's got this gigantic bill, which he presumes must be a mistake, because he leads a very simple life. He doesn't have any extravagances, and he doesn't think of himself as being particularly happy or been particularly lucky in love, for example. So why this huge bill? So he gets into a correspondence, sort of a phone conversation with the company that has issued this invoice, in order to try and find out what's going on and whether he can get it lowered or sort of struck off completely, because he simply doesn't have the money to pay for it. And so what the book gives you is the conversations that he has with the woman at this office where he's trying to sort out what to do about this invoice. And as I say, I don't want to say too much about the book, except to say that if you can imagine that those people who had been happiest or got the most from life would get the highest bill, then this is about somebody looking at their own life and maybe reassessing it slightly and wondering whether they might be happier than they realised, or that their life may have been more fulfilling than they realised. And through the conversations with this woman, Maud, something of a relationship begins to develop because of their frequent communication. And I will say no more than that. As I say, it's a brilliant idea, and it is done with the same kind of trademark humour. And actually, do you know what? The way to really best describe the sort of tone of the book, Jonas came to visit us and he recorded some sections from the book. And when you hear him narrating his own stuff, you get a really good idea about the sort of the right tone of voice and how to read the narrator. Jonas is actually an actor back in Sweden, so he's very good at reading his own stuff. But yes, I'll put links below here to our SoundCloud page where you can hear him doing some readings from The Invoice, and they'll give you the perfect idea about the tone of this book. If you think that you might be interested in winning a copy of this book, it's very simple. Make sure you're subscribed, leave a comment below, and I will pick 1, 2, 3 people to win copies of The Invoice next week. That's all for this week. That's all I have to say to you. Next week I'll be talking about something completely different. But in the meantime, welcome back to Vintage. Thank you for following the vlog, and I'll see you next week. Take care.